Thank you, Lord Mayor. Seems a good time to clear the chamber now. It's going to take time, I feel, as well.
You have 20 minutes.
Once you're doing that timer, please present the Green Party's budget proposal. So, thank you. It goes without saying that we're in a time of austerity. The government of cuts affect us, you know, especially in local councils, but that's across the country, not just in local councils, but otherwise as well. They're, of course, really big hard for, you know, local people in this city. Should take, well, echo straight away that the banks and officers have worked on this and trying to put this budget of many millions of pounds together. So, crisis social care is something that, you know, we're trying to avoid. We all know about this crisis. We all agree it's a national issue requiring a national solution. But we're also finding important decisions made at a local level. And we can see the officers have got some plans in place for that. But once again, there have been substantial overspends in the provision of social care. We'll just see how those plans that the officers have prepared do over the year, and he's looking very carefully. We also need to be careful that to recognise that the amount of spending on social care is still dwarfed by the amount of health spending in Sheffield. Health service has a far bigger budget. In my view, it's essential that we as the elected members scrutinise those decisions. So we look at health and social care spending in the round, and it's our job to make sure that money is spent as well as possible. And so I strongly support the work of the Health and Social Care Scrutiny Committee. I know that this is quite a view shared by everyone in here. Not everyone shares the view about magic money trees either. Some people think the magic money trees don't exist, but of course we know they do, especially in Northern Ireland, where there's been quite a bit of magic money tree planting growing. By contrast, in Sheffield, I'd say we have a couple of magic money trees now. Thank you, John. But you haven't seen that notice, but back in 2011, yeah, before we signed the street head contract, we were spending £39 million on highways maintenance. And this year, will be £79 million. So that's a £40 million difference. That £40 million increase in spending is about the same as the total budget gap that we're looking for in this year, 2018-19. Maybe that's the answer. I'm just saying that to give some perspective on the massive problems that Council of Labour's described today, the most difficult budget ever, but possibly an answer to how that's come about. Not a comment on whether we're getting good value for money on highways. That's a separate issue. The point here is that cuts in public services are very closely related to these long-term contracts. And of course, they're contracts that we now know our grandchildren will be paying for up to 2057. So I have a feeling we're going to be saving this for the next 40 years. But of course, that will be long after contractors like Amy have gone home and taken the profits with them. So that's why I'm saying we need to start thinking about a green, sustainable approach to finances. So we've got some modest adjustments here. We exempt the young care leavers at the age of 25 in council tax. That's a help and start off and always the independent life, and that's been proposed to our motion to the council recently. We'll have another officer helping tenants deal with poor standards in private rented housing. We'll have another officer bringing empty homes back into use. It provides much needed new homes, deals with the blight of empty homes on the streets. We'll create further jobs from bringing brownfield sites back into use. That's to avoid building on refuel sites. We've got more projects to develop some container homes. There's some exciting new proposals that might or might not work out to be new, affordable, low-cost housing, which is desperately needed. We need to test how this work out. The council's in a unique position to not bring that about. We'll bring some of the empty shops back into use on Kingston Street and Charles Street. Something to support Sheffield independent businesses. We'll have a much needed heritage officer in the city. We'll make the city safer. We'll fund an extra 8 PCSOs to keep people safe on the streets, not for policing tree protests, by the way. We'll offer a paid worker in every branch library. We'll reverse the cuts to advice services and the voluntary sector. There's a cut here of just £50,000, which in council terms is pretty small. But the estimate is it will cause the loss of either 9 or 18 full-time jobs in the voluntary sector. and say, let's take either 9 or 18, because we're informed finding them and it's taken by the officer. But the point here is that this is only £50,000 can cause the loss of all those jobs. And that is because of the huge benefit that volunteers bring in. And having paid jobs in the voluntary sector, a huge effect. So a small cut by this council magnifies into a huge effect outside the council that's or someone else's problem. Similarly, we're reversing cuts to the one pots and small grants for community groups that are available through them. And of course, that are being proposed by this administration impact directly on those vulnerable people in the city. So that's both the advice centre cuts and the small grants. Disproportionately are women on BME communities, on disabled people, and on people with very low incomes. And also, it affects people who need help in time of crisis. And that's why I say these costs are wrong, and we can reverse them. And on inequality, the council has yet to publish its gender pay gap data. Deadline's the end of March, time is ticking on. We would tackle inequality head on by closing the gap between the highest of pay and those paid in the council here. So that means we would reduce executive pay. There's 111 officers earning more than £50,000 a year. And of course, it's that figure for just one post that equates to 9 or 18 posts in the voluntary sector. Local transport would ensure that from now on all local transport funding is used on sustainable modes of transport only. Now we've got the yellow bikes in the city. We want to see money specifically set aside to make cycling safer, protection of the cyclists. Rather, some financial incentives, more financial incentives for taxi drivers to get low emission vehicles, and will help the public monitor air pollution. We'll encourage the use of public transport, discourage people to think that just driving to the central park on someone's doorstep for free. We'll do this by supporting residents who vote for the local schemes. We'll start to work on the workplace parking levy, somewhere in Nottingham's leading well ahead of Sheffield. We'll show the system works, we could have that in Sheffield. And we'll set about the council cleaning up its act with plastic waste. We'll look at a project to get an officer working on ways to the council can reduce its use of single-use plastics. In addition to that, we support the installation of some drinking water fountains around the city. That's to encourage people to use their own refillable bottles and not keep buying more plastic. That's also helps with it. Provide more outdoor gym equipment for parks. We reverse funding cuts to theatres and museums. We're creating more jobs with some larger energy efficiency schemes in the schools in the city. So these are all good for jobs and for the community and for the environment. We've estimated that these proposed proposals will generate a net increase of 41 jobs above what the administration is proposing. But that's in addition to the investment in the present and, more importantly, for the future. So finally, the ASA, but it's a long-standing call that Bryan have had to open up these meetings to broadcasting. There's no real reason nowadays why that shouldn't be done. And of course, at the end of all these speeches, we're going to have a roll call of votes because the equipment is broken down again. So we say it's time to replace this, and the equipment goes here, goes with the equipment that's needed for the webcast. So, for those reasons, this budget.
May I call on Councillor Robert Murphy to second the amendment? You may speak for the remainder of 20-minute time. Thank you, Councillor Murphy.
Your Mayor, I'd like to echo thanks to officers who were great this year in helping us sort out our budget. It gives me great pleasure to second the Green Budget Amendment this year. As regular attenders of this meeting will know, it's almost becoming like a preview of next year's Labour budget. last year's Green Budget included a 20-mile an hour zone for the city centre, something that would protect residents across the city from injuring the city centre. We included money for brownfield sites, and I understand that's something that's coming forward in the council meeting later this month. This administration will be working on bringing grounds and field sites back into use by the creative fund, something else we proposed last year. The transport strategy includes a mention of working up the workplace parking levy, something that they were turned down last year, that they might be doing in the future. And finally, this council is inching towards broadcasting of these meetings, little step by little step. I can see why they don't want to record these meetings. I can see why it might not work good when it's seeing cabinet members or affluent members of the public or the council leader talking over the Lord Mayor. I can see why this might not be the greatest thing to do, but I think it is inevitable that sooner or later these meetings will be recorded by the council. So once again, we are suffering as a city from the decisions made by a government in Westminster. But once again, we are hampered in our budget by decisions made by this and previous administrations. Councillors that signed off deals and debts to the benefit of their generation and left the bill for our and future generations. Tens of millions of pounds in this budget are going on debt repayments and long-term contracts that this council has little control over. So times are tough, but some budgets remain protected. The policy officers working for the Labour Group remain protected, and the high wages of the top officers on this council remain protected. What this council needs is vision and real opposition. And again, it's the Greens that provide it. When the Labour Council When the Labour Council cuts litter collection services, it's the Greens that cut the litter. While the Labour Council oversees parts of the city centre turning into a ghost town for a decade, it is the Greens that will put Sheffield businesses back into the city centre, offering opportunity, jobs and improved streets in. And finally, and ironically considering the discussion earlier on regarding unacceptable bullying, whereas this Labour Council works with South Yorkshire's police to intimidate local communities, the Greens would help local communities with more neighbourhood PCSOs. So, Council, please, don't wait another year to look forward and look ahead. Vote for this budget amendment now.
Councillor Murphy, that was an unacceptable comment that you made earlier. I'm not going to play on the point, but I will tell you that I am very unhappy that that was in your budget speech. Please sit down now. I'm going to move to the next amendment. Thank you. May I call upon Councillor Jack Clarkson to move amendment. Councillor
Clarkson, you as your seconder may speak
for
up to a
combined total of 20 minutes.
Colleagues,
can you second
that,
please?
Councillor Clarkson. Thank you. I didn't find anything
really
acceptable. Just
for people to... Point to Lord Mayor.
Thank you, Lord Mayor.
Lord Mayor, darling, may I please take a chance to come to
the clock? Can you just stop the clock?
I must say, we'll stop the clock. Councillor Murphy made an accusation or an allegation that I am bullying and intimidating people, and I'd like him to provide the evidence. We'll take it back. Said I was working with the police to bully and intimidate people. Provide the evidence, we'll take it back.
Councillor Murphy?
Do you want to respond? You either need to provide evidence or you need to withdraw that statement.
Which statement, then?
The statement that the Labour, this Labour councillor is bullying and attacking.
Sorry, unfortunately, I'll be...
To intimidate.
Working with the police. As far as I'm concerned, this council and the actions of this council in recent weeks, and this council even apologised for what happened on Russell Road. I think it's obvious we have caught the police.
I'm speaking to the point that you actually read out that this council is working with the police to intimidate members.
If I said working with the police to intimidate before that, I would say the work council is working with the police and the police are intimidating local communities.
If I can, the apology that was made regarding the incident in Russell's Road was the apology for disturbing people. There is no way that he was bullying and intimidating people. There is no way that council is involved. The police are responsible for policing the streets. As was mentioned on the radio this morning by Councillor Scriven when he spoke, and he said quite rightly, if people are breaking the law, then that is a matter for the police. And nobody supports people breaking the law. The police are upholding the law on the streets. The council are not working with the police to intimidate or bully. And I think Councillor Murphy should really withdraw those comments he made.
He has just changed it back. Is that correct, Councillor? You've added to that statement.
No, Mayor, I think it's not for this chamber to decide whether the police are intimidating or not. I think it was for the local communities to decide whether they've been intimidated or not. I think I'm not aware that that is the power of this chamber to decide what those people think.
Lord Mayor, we accept that withdrawal for the comment that the Labour Council is working with the police to intimidate and bully. We accept that withdrawal.
Thank you, Councillor John. So,
I'm from the Greens. Cut managers' pay. Oh, we want you to work harder. I deal with the budget. I'm cut. I deal with the demand. I'll do it with fewer staff. Our council staff are public servants who take pride in the work they do for Sheffield. They're proud of Sheffield and proud of what happens in Sheffield. They should not be undervalued like this every year, year on year.
And we recognise that. And for all the platitudes that come from the other side, the opposition groups, they then turn around and say, well done, thank you, we would have cut your wages. Well, we recognise the hard work that goes in. We recognise the commitment from people. We've heard some interesting things in the budget amendments today from the opposition groups. At Councillor Murphy, there are three opposition groups, and the Greens are not the largest. I do recognise that the Lib Dems are the largest opposition group, although you seem to think you're the opposition. But you do oppose a lot of things. You oppose a lot of things out there in the city. But the biggest thing, the biggest concern about your budget is the lack of information about things, the lack of what you do, for all the things that you talk about and shout about in the city. You're out there on the streets talking about people, the tree party, but you're out there and you're talking and supporting all these people, but when it comes down to it, where is there anything in your amendment about what you do differently? Absolutely nothing at all. Absolutely nothing. And then you talk about some of the things, and Councillor Johnson, I just point out to you, it's a roll call in the chamber for the budget council meeting because you have to record every councillor's vote. It's a requirement. It's nothing to do with the technology. I think if you check with the officers, they will tell you they have to record the vote. It's not the technology. It's a word of that.
Excuse me, please, carry on.
Well, Mayor, as I was just pointing out, and I think the chief executive was looking to point out and advise Councillor Johnson, it is a requirement that you record everybody's vote, nothing to do with this.